With a simple like that, you can create enough energy to run your lab.
Sounds good.
Understand the behavior of the plasma, understand the behavior of the universe, they're all the same in different scales. Understand the behavior of the universe, they're all the same in different scales.
Yes, exactly.
So basically going back to transferring energy in the lungs, does that mean if you can create a reactor and condition which is with the same energy like oxygen, you can use it without using the lungs?
Yes, that's what we do with our patients in the medical section.
Oh, that sounds great.
This is why when we have a COPD patient, we give them a pump that does not deliver oxygen. It creates and delivers the information of the conversion of helium in the lung. So in fact, the lung goes on the rest condition and you just transfer helium energy plasma across the wall with the information. And this time of repair allows the lung to repair itself because it's not used for its function. This is one of the problems we see with COPD. COPD people, I have had a COPD guy who comes in, he can't walk for not even, when he walked on the table, we have to wait about 10, 15 minutes before he could say his first word. And then a few months later, he came back and he sat and he stopped talking and says, "You've done nothing for me. I still have my COPD." I said, "Guy, because you know in the foundation you pay if you like." He says, "I don't want to pay because I haven't seen any difference." And I said to myself, "I have a video of this stupid man. You came in 3 months ago, it took you 12 minutes, 15 minutes before you could even say the first word. Now you come in and you sit and see, I know difference."
Now his first word is to complain.
No, it's to cheat, it's the habit of the man.
Yeah.
But I see a lot of people come in and they say nothing has changed, and then when the husband is not there, everything is changed. Because in front of the husband, they cannot be good, otherwise they have to do more at home. So we see this behavior, but we use these pumps to allow the information of the plasma of a helium to transfer across the lung. So the body does not need to be used for the conversion. So they do that very much like in the new heart operations. They don't take the heart out. They put a second heart next to the body for 12 months or so, which takes the pressure of the original of the human heart. And in that time, the heart gets time to repair itself, and they take the pump away afterwards. So, you know, these are the new, we see it now in practice in the same thing, but all these starts with the same as your pump, what you have there. You see the glow, understand why the glow. And this glow, as you see, the further it goes near to the to your vacuum pump, the color changes, becomes less and less. It's a stronger near your cylinder. So it means there are different matters, because different magnetic gravitational field plasma create different brightness. So you already seen it, but you never understood it. So if you want copper, go near there, create a condition in that place. If you put a rod in, you can continuously vacuum copper out.
Cool.
If you go further away, you want oxygen all the time. You continuously, at that point, convert oxygen. This is why in the universe, or let's say in our solar system, we see cosmic dust in the boundaries and from the Earth and before Earth up. We don't see that much cosmic dust near the Sun because the materials haven't lost enough of their matter, energy, to become matter level. And then as they become different level, different strength, you see the cosmic dust is the wrong word. It's the solar dust, because these are the conversion of the energy magnetic field of the Sun which as they lose their strength, they become matter in different positions. So cosmic dust is a wrong word. It doesn't exist. In the same way, in your system, you create different materials. You see different light, different lightning, different magnetic field, gravitational fields. You tap into it, you have what you like. You want gold, how many kilos? You understand?
Exactly.
So this is the process of not creating energy, creating motion, but creating matter in the energy level that we don't need to use, consume food in a space.
Right.
You're in a very nice track. You're doing a very nice job. But these are, I did this about 30 years ago. So
yes, exactly. Well, we're on the fast track, but we're trying also to go one step at a time and to try to understand what's going on as we move along. So I mean, we start with a simple plasma ball, and that sort of gives us an idea of what, you know, what that world is about a little bit. So. And now every week we progress quite quickly, I think, and we're doing better all the time.
Where are you now? Can I see your latest reactor if you want to show us?
Well, I don't have an actual reactor at this point, except we have a little setup here, for example, with a polycarbonate glass and a vacuum chamber, and it has a... electrodes on here that we can put high voltage into and get another effect out of this little setup, you might say. We've also have quite a nice chamber here that we can also use as it's a glass chamber, heavy. It's made for a lighting system, but it will be a good vacuum chamber to use, or at least an outer chamber to have a globe, say a rotating globe on the inside. Basically, the vacuum chamber that I built, the larger one here, I look at it as more of an outer container for an inner system. Like, I could see possibly using an actual plasma ball as a globe system, and I can grind off the little nib on the bottom and put a hose on and suck the air out of this and then put in the mixture that we wish to use in it. So that you see is a possibility. We've already been able to spin this up to 4,000 RPM, and we observe the changes inside the globe. The tendrils tend to change. The one tendril will go straight to... And at one certain point, right about now, the tendril from the center of the globe goes straight up to the top of the globe, the top here.
How do you feed it?
Well, we've done it a couple of different ways. One is with its actual little high voltage power supply, and
has batteries.
It has four AAA batteries in it, and it just slips on top of the globe that way, because the globe has a sort of a
tube
finger inside, you might say, that this part can go into, you know.
Yeah, and then you put this one on that rotating magnet.
We can.
Look at the beam. Yeah, it's quite amazing.
Wow, yeah. And put this in. We put this into the vacuum chamber and tried it just plain, and then.
Oh, there it goes.
We determined that it made the globe go out, and then eventually we figured out that it was shorting out in the high voltage transformer here as part of the chart. You know, part of the. High voltage system. It was just arcing over and causing this blue glow over the whole circuitry here, essentially. And that's what happens at the low vacuum condition. So then we took this part and put it outside of our vacuum chamber and just ran a wire in to run the glow. So we mounted the electronics onto the bottom of the vacuum chamber.
Plug her in.
Nice.
And we tried it that way. And then we've also run the globe with the high voltage from our car transformer or car coil setup. So we've tried different ways to fire it.
Ask him what we can do next.
You don't need to ask him to ask me. Ask him yourself.
Hi there.
Hey, this is Paul.
I recently immigrated from Holland. Now living in Canada.
Man.
Yeah,
Dutchman.
It's too busy in Holland.
Ask your question.
Okay.
What kind of experiment we can do to make any progress towards the Keshe technology? Because right now we're just playing a bit with electricity and vacuum, but it would be cool to have some direction.
I'm pretty sure if you use the globe you just showed me.
Yes.
And you understand the way you created the vacuum and in the secondary cylinder with your vacuum pump.
Yeah.
Change the characteristics of plasma.
Yes.
With a simple like that, you can create enough energy to run your lab.
Sounds good.
Well, that's a big hint.
That is a very. You see, I have a habit. I don't teach nobody nothing, but I tell you what it can be done. Because if I do, that's one of the reasons we don't put our systems out so much. Mm-hmm. Because then the people think, oh, that's it, we copy that. This way we allow thoughts and different ways to come out.
It doesn't become
a photocopying machine. So, in fact, with what you have there, if you can put an electrode, you can maintain your plasma and you put an electrode. Not even an electrode, you can create a condition that you can absorb the energy of the plasma.
Mm-hmm.
I think in that chamber you can produce enough energy to run your house for about 20, 30 years.
Right, sounds good.
But whoa! Now, what would be the activating factor? Like normally, I've seen in the patent, for example, there'll be radon gas in the outer part of, like, say we had the globe inside the. You've got your.
Stop.
Okay.
Go back to understanding the. The property of matter. Yeah? In a chamber, when you put argon, it does not stay argon. Yeah? A gamma ray does not stay gamma ray. Gamma ray stays in the gamma ray as long as it has the strength of what we call gamma ray. Then become different rays. Yeah? This name has caused the biggest confusion. Use them as a strength level, not as a matter level or energy level. Yeah? So, if you use argon, what is argon? What is atomic structure? What is gravitational magnetic field structure? You create a condition that it reduces or releases most of its matter faster or slower. You understand? So, if you put argon in, you can use the inner layers of argon to release gamma for you or beta for you or X-ray or soft X-ray or even create matter. You have to understand the walk away from matter and work in the plasma, and then the simplest way is think of the solar system and move away from the sun. And you see what things you get. I think book number 4, when it's released, hopefully in the next couple of months, a lot of people will put the whole package together. If you read, you see, book number 1 was to explain the structure of matter, which, to put it the correct way. Book number 2 was the structure of the light. It wasn't to talk about the light. It's to
carry the information how matters move in the universe.